The Redeemer's Coming, The Sherlock Holmes Advent Calendar, by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle and Nora Godwin, narrated by Bryan Godwin. Part 22, The Covenant of Evil. Quickly taking Holmes's leg injury into account, we marched through the corridors of the Abbey. We passed the lavatory where two Franciscans stood shaking their heads in front of the distant plank, and the chapel where a monk carpenter was busy building a new confessional box. But we only took notice of this on the sidelines and remained focused. Finally, we stood at the door of the office room and entered without further delay. Brother Francis sat behind his desk, his arms folded in front of his chest. "Gentlemen," he said, "I was already waiting for you." "We're not here to say goodbye," I replied. The abbot nodded slowly, only saying, "I know." "Then you might know," Holmes provocatively suggested, "that we found Mariah Taylor." The remark did not fail to have any effect. Brother Francis jumped up and exclaimed excitedly, "Where is she? What did you do with her?" Holmes remained calm, saying, "She is safe, especially from you." "That's unfortunate," Brother Francis replied as he approached us, his walking stick in hand. "I wish you hadn't. I wish you just left after the death of Brother Peter. Then we would be spared a lot." "Prison is what you will not be spared of," I replied defiantly. "And if I have a say in it, the gallows are waiting for you." The abbot shook his head. "Your enthusiasm and honor, Dr. Watson," he said calmly. "But you misunderstand the situation. I'm not going anywhere." With these words, Brother Francis suddenly pulled a revolver from the sleeve of his cowl and pointed it at us. I wonder if we should pull out our firearms now, because, after all, the old man would not be fast enough to shoot us both. But Holmes guessed my mind, looked me in the face, and shook his head. I sat down. "Instead," I said, "you will never get away with it, Brother Francis. Your plan has failed. You have failed. Deservedly, because you are nothing but a heretic who has fallen away from faith."
"Don't insult me,"
the abbot shouted, grasping his stick at the bottom and slapping the metal knob in my face, "and do not insult God's plan." Shortly dazed, I inevitably fell to my knees. I grabbed my left cheek and noticed that I had suffered a bleeding wound. Immediately, I straightened up again. "Haven't you spilled enough blood with your walking stick yet?" I asked. "That was the weapon you used to kill Brother Emmanuel and Brother Nicholas, wasn't it?" This presumption was true because Holmes nodded approvingly to me, but Brother Francis ignored that question. "If I could ask for your weapons now," he continued, "or did you come here without them? Take them out very slowly and throw them behind you." Again, we looked at each other and Holmes wordlessly told me to follow the instruction. So we did as ordered. Holmes took his revolver and placed it on the floor, then pushed it backwards with his foot toward the door. I did the same with my pistol. I wasn't comfortable with it, but I trusted that Holmes had a plan, and that was the case. "Brother Francis," he began in a calm voice, "you have no chance. Give up. Today the papal delegate will appear in the monastery. What do you want to tell him?" "Let that be my concern," the abbot replied, unmoved. "You will no longer be concerned with this issue." "Cardinal Fossanova will see through you," said Holmes, now a little louder. "He will get behind the secret of the abbey and hold you accountable, because you are a sneaky murderer, a kidnapper, and arsonist, and a mean, vile rapist." The provocation worked, and once again the abbot pulled out his walking stick to beat Holmes, but he was prepared for it. He quickly dropped and rolled to the side, causing the stick to go nowhere. In the same move, Holmes hit Brother Francis's legs with his crutch, causing him to fall. His revolver flew above the desk and landed far away on the ground. Now we were all unarmed. For fractions of a second, we thought about what to do. It should be possible for me to overpower the fallen abbot with my superior physical force, but I turned around to pick up my pistol again. But I was not going to get that lucky, because at that very moment the door opened. Reverend Blake stepped in and made a surprised face and almost stumbled upon my weapon. He picked her up and said, "But gentlemen, what's going on here?" I sighed in relief. "Thank God you're here, Father," I cried. "Brother Francis is the real perpetrator. Point the gun at him." But Holmes shook his head. "Don't try, Watson," he said. "He's not going to do anything like that."
"But
why?" I stammered without understanding. Because the Reverend...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.